Welcome to the second Trailblazers episode. I actually just completed a task which is 50 salmons. I can't believe that is a medium task, but 53 points, I guess. Another 50 points for 50 fishing. I still have 324 feathers, so it might be possible to get to like 58 or something. Okay, I got way more than that. I have 137 feathers left and I just got 60 fishing, which was actually 100 points. So that is another task done and a lot of points. It's enough food with level 60 and I'm not really going to get more tasks done anyways if I keep fishing, so I'm just going to end there. I have like 500 foods now in the bank, I just have to cook them. I did some cooking but not that much and I'm already 43. What I'm doing right now is I'm getting 30 laps done on the Draenor Village rooftop agility course. That gives actually 50 points as well as of course a task completion. I also completed one task by picking up a Mark of Grace. So I only need to do 3 more tasks to unlock another area. Only 2 more tasks to do now. I just completed the 30 laps and I actually ended on 37 agility, which is pretty crazy. But 50 points as well, and I actually know 2 very easy tasks that I can do, so I will be able to unlock a new area in just a second. Picked a pineapple for one task, and then I just have to go and talk to this guy, pay him like 800 GP, 875, and that is the second task done. I just have to enter here pretty much, and we get the task done. So now I can choose another area. So I've been thinking a bit, and I was going to pick Kandrin as I've been talking about so much, and it is an area that I will definitely have to unlock. And if I look at the unlocks, there are so many good quests, like Monkey Madness 1, the Once More Favor Swan Song for the Monkfish I can fish, Monkey Madness 2 is just insane for Xenites, and the drops of course is the Xenites, Occult Necklace, the Dragon Chain Body, Smoke Battle Stave, the Trident, all kinds of good stuff. But if I go over to the Mauritania area, which is the one I actually want to get to in the end at least, and do a lot of content in, there's a lot of different drops here, and Black Masks are one of the really good ones, as I'm going to primarily do melee, and getting a Black Mask is probably not too hard. And of course, with soon getting the double drop rate on items, it's going to be even easier, as well as a lot of good Slayer stuff with the Slayer Tower unlock, and Barrows, of course, I will be able to do fairly soon. So I'm actually going to unlock the Mauritania area now already, and I can actually do the Sepulture as well, which is going to give me some money, some prayer potions, because you can buy the Hallowed Sack now. So I'm going to try that out and see what happens. I'm just going to do it, and it will go as it goes, you know? You can't do much about it now, so I wonder how many tasks I will have to complete to unlock another area. So last one it was 60, and now it's 80 tasks, so quite a lot. Of course, if I'm going to be a lot in Mauritania, I do need to get that Ghost Speak amulet, so I just went here and picked it up. Just from completing a zombie task that I got from Duradel and training up my melee stats, which are by the way now 30 attack and 20 strength, I did get actually 2 tasks from equipping a mithril sword, was 10 points I think, and then medium task for an adamant weapon, so 50 points for that one. And I'm going to have to use melee in the near future here because I don't have any money to buy runes. I picked up a task from Messena and got 45 hill giants, which is actually perfect because I'm actually heading over to the Ectophantus right now just to use some of the bones from the normal zombies, and I think it should be at least one task to use the Ectophantus, and maybe I can get some prayer levels as well. There's actually 2 Mauritania tasks that are kind of funny. You have to go to Mostly Harmless for one, and I did solve that by using the Trouble Brewing minigame teleports. And then there's one for Harmony Island, but you just can't charter there. I'm not sure how they thought about this, but maybe that's an oversight, but I just don't know how you're supposed to get there. Oh, so you can actually get to Harmony Island by talking to Brother Tranquility, so I guess that's a way to do it, but to get to Mostly Harmless in the first place, you do have to use that minigame teleport, it seems like. 50 points for completing the Canifis rooftop agility course. I just went and got 40 agility in Varrok, meanwhile doing some hill giants, so I could complete that task. So I've been thinking quite a bit, and I think that I can actually solve a lot of my issues with Puro Puro, and it is actually a couple of tasks in here, but primarily to get my hunter level up. I think it's going to be a very good thing, and also I can get some good items from the Implings when I get a higher hunter level. And I can get, for example, Dragon Weaponry even from Magpie Implings, which is not too high. So it's going to be very interesting, and I can only right now catch baby Implings. So let's get some levels. Because I unlocked Mauritania, I can actually pretty fast train Hunter with Swamp Lizards that I just unlocked, and it should be, I guess it should be around here. There you go, 29 Swamp Lizards. I think it's actually a task to do that as well. So I'm just going to power level some Hunter now, and then get back here where I can actually catch some more of these. 48 Hunter, I'm getting about 400,000 Hunter experience an hour, and we actually got 500 total level, which was only 10 points, but it is a task regardless. Nice, nice, here we go. 65 Hunter, I can now catch the Magpie Implings. That should be a very good way to make some money now that I'm completely broke. So let's go back to Puro Puro and hopefully catch some. Got 50 points for catching 50 Implings, and there's another task that is 200 Implings that gives 100 points, and it should go pretty fast. But I actually did catch a Magpie Impling extremely early. I'm actually catching mostly Essence Implings because they are very good runes. Let's see what I get. Cosmic Runes and then Eclectic, that's nothing too good. Let's see what the Magpie is going to give me. Mystic Boots, that is definitely pretty good. Wait, that was a task? Equip a piece of the Mystic set? 50 points. Oh, the easiest points of my life. Second Magpie Impling is going to give us Snapdragon Seed. Would be good on the main game. I think the best thing I could probably get from a Magpie Impling is a Dragon Dagger, so let's get that right now. Sinister Key. I don't think I can actually use that right now, but it might have a very high ALK value actually. 48, yeah, that never mind. I do have to unlock Kandarin to be able to use the Sinister Key, but I'm just going to save it. I got another Magpie, let's get something good. Runite Bar, that is insane ALK, it has to be. Oh, it's actually not that high, but yeah, it's still decent. Actually getting pretty lucky now, I got another one, fifth one, and Black Dragonhide? Yeah, that's probably not worth that much. Managed to collect 3 Magpie Implings, let's open all of them and see what we get. First one gives Misty Gloves, now I have both gloves and the boots, nice, nice, nice. Second one, Pineapple Seed, that is terrible! I don't think I can use that for anything, so I'm just going to drop it. And this one, Rune Square Shield, that is actually so good! Look at what I'm wearing! That's the best shield I currently have, so that is a massive upgrade. There we go, that is the 200 Implings caught for 100 points, and my current progress is, by the way, 66 tasks until another area, and only 480 points until that third relic. And I do have a Magpie Impling, so let's open that real quick. Ring of Forging, not very useful, unfortunately. Because there's no more tasks here now, I'm just going to stop hunting Implings and probably get back to doing some tasks. But I did catch another Magpie Impling, so let's see what the last one is going to give me. Amulet of Power! That is insanely good! I had no amulet with stats, so perfect. Easy Trek completed for 10 points, and I'm going to use this token on probably an XP tome. I'm hoping that it's actually boosted, so let's see what skill I get. I get Woodcutting Tome. 9,000 woodcutting experience almost. Wow, okay, that's a lot of levels. Defeat a werewolf completed. Defeat a Tsar for 3 tokel is now also done. So the tasks that you can do is actually divided into all the different areas, and then there's all section that I didn't even know about. I mean, that's why some of the tasks just popped up randomly and I was like, well, how is this a task? They're from here. There's so many easy ones that I probably have left to complete that can give me a lot of tasks done. So I'm just going to go through a bunch of these. I'm not going to show it because it would be way too repetitive, like craft any rune. Like that's the easiest thing ever. But currently I have 63 tasks left. So let's see where I can end up. And these are my stats. So if you want to look at them just before they're going to update, let's go. Just had time so far to do a couple of tasks, but I'm going to use an antique lamp from finishing the Lumbridge and Draenor easy diary, and I'm definitely going to use this on Herblore. Oh my god, I can't! Oh, that was one of my plans, because I can't really get Eye of Newt very easily to get my Herblore up, but if the skill have to be over 30, I'm not sure what I'm going to use this on right now. I'm probably just going to use it on Slayer or something, even though that's such an easy skill. Maybe I should just save it. finally, that is the completion of the task that gives me the third relic, which was just fletch a willow shortbow. These are my current stats. I've leveled a couple of them that were very low, like mining and smithing, and got some woodcutting levels, some fletching levels, and all around just some levels. And this is now the time to choose the next relic. I am 100% sure which one I'm already picking, and it is going to be Fluid Strikes. It is extremely good. It gives me pretty much double the attack speed with melee weapons, also 25% more accuracy, you take 15% less damage from everything, and your hit points is restoring at 4 times the rate. Extremely good, and it's going to help me so much with getting my melee combat stats up, and also items from sources will be 2 times as common. Very nice. I'm not sure exactly what that means, if it means that rare drops are at double the rate, or if every single drop is doubled. We will have to see. Oh my god, imagine this on the nightmare when I eventually get there. Look at this attack speed, this is insane. I'm going to get an abyssal bludgeon in the future from the abyssal sire and use that on the nightmare. And having that attack at this speed, well, a bit slower than this, is going to be insane. By the way, why I'm killing the wall beast? Oh, that's another task done, I guess. But why I'm actually killing the wall beast is because there is a random task to just kill a wall beast that gives 50 points. So I guess I'm getting a total of 100 points after I actually defeat this. Let's get that done, and let's see if the achievement pops up. There we go, 50 points for that, easy. I was looking at weapon upgrades with the Mauritania area unlocked, and I have a adamant sword right now, which is tier 30, but there is actually pretty much a buyable rune scimitar in the Mauritania area, here at the Mostly Harmless area. If you talk to Smith with a Book of Piracy in your inventory, you can buy a rapier, and it is going to cost me 25.6k, I'm pretty sure. If I go through the dialogue here, I should be able to buy one. It's a lot of dialogue, and it is going to be equal to, there you could see, 25.6k, a rune scimitar, but it is stab instead of slash. So here we have the weapon. You can see it has a lot of melee strength, more than my adamant sword, and this is going to be my weapon of choice for quite a while until I get a dragon scimitar from unlocking the Kandarin area. It is a very nice looking weapon, actually. I really like it, and I will be training mostly attack with it, as it is the best option for the rapier. With that, I'm going to end the video here, and in the next one, I am very early on in that video going to unlock the Kandarin area. Even though I have 31 tasks left now, I do want to rush into the more late game content as soon as possible in terms of videos. So expect me to have done quite a lot of progress for the next video. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe if you want to see when I post these videos. And have a good one, guys. Take care.